The Apple Vision Pro is what the company calls a spatial computing headset. Now, it's far from the first of its kind, but this is the first time Apple has entered the fray, which brings with it a lot of uniquely Apple pros and cons. But what is it actually like to use one of these headsets? And should anyone actually spend $3,500 on one? The setup process is very quick. You put it on, the lenses adjust to your eyes. Obviously, it's a bit more involved if you wear glasses and you have to put in prescription lenses. You pull your iPhone out, it syncs up with your iCloud account. It's very seamless, very frictionless. The same goes for navigation, which is more intuitive than just about any other headset I've used before. It's just your eyes, it's just your hands, and the overall navigation does feel really good. So what you're seeing right now is me highlighting different app icons on the home screen. I'm doing that with just my eyes. And once it comes time to open that app, literally just pinch with my fingers. Those are, for the most part, the only controls you're gonna have to worry about. You've got your main power button. You've got your digital crown for making a number of adjustments. The voice control is also very impressive on here. So one of the few times where Siri actually comes in handy a lot, I can say, Siri, open Slack. And just like that, here's my Slack window. Not to be hyperbolic, but I feel like I'm living in that sci-fi future that movies promised us 20 years ago. Now, one area where the Vision Pro really shines is multitasking. You could basically open all of your usual Apple apps and a bunch of third-party options and have them floating in 3D. But what really takes things to the next level is Mac virtual display. So I am now seeing my MacBook screen in the Vision Pro in this virtual space. And it's essentially a fully resizable 4K monitor that I can move and use alongside my Vision Pro apps. And the really awesome thing is that this supports universal control. So now that my MacBook and my Vision Pro are synced up, I can use my MacBook keyboard and trackpad to control everything in front of me, including my MacBook screen and my Vision Pro apps. This to me is the real game changer and one of the coolest use cases of the Vision Pro, because this headset works well enough for productivity. You do have most of the basic apps, but at the end of the day, you're kind of just using iPad apps blown up in 3D. If you have a Mac, it really brings together the multitasking experience on this Vision Pro. I will say the Vision Pro has really good pass-through cameras, so I can very clearly see everything around me. Should you go to a Starbucks and order your coffee with one on, like some people have done? I don't think so, for many reasons. But for when you're just navigating around your apartment and you need to do your day-to-day things, the cameras on here are very sharp. I would say a little bit better than what you get on the Quest 3. Now, I need to stress that this thing is not meant to be used outside. Apple itself says you should not do that. But just for science's sake, we're gonna strap this thing on and take the subway and see how it goes. All right, should I start walking towards the train?
Yeah.
Oh, wait, I gotta put my password in. Now, if there's one reason to actually go ahead and blow your mortgage payment on one of these, it is the movie watching experience. I'm gonna start with just watching a movie and go through that whole experience. So I'm gonna hit the old environments button here, select cinema, and now I am in my own personal movie theater. There are also a number of third-party entertainment apps that are built from the ground up to take advantage of Vision Pro, my favorite of which being Disney Plus. So this app gives you a handful of virtual environments you can put yourself in when you're watching movies. Let's head into Avengers Tower. And now we are no longer here in the studio. I am now sitting at the top of Avengers Tower in New York City. Again, this is already super cool. I geeked out the first time I saw this. I'm still kind of geeking out now. And it gets especially cool when you hit play. The entire scene just turned to night. I could focus better on the movie. It is a very, very cool way to watch movies, and definitely the biggest selling point that there currently is for the Vision Pro, in my opinion. Now, for all of the things that the Vision Pro does right, it unfortunately is just not very comfortable to wear. On paper, it's not much heavier than, say, a MetaQuest 3, and despite the fact that you do get a number of options for customizing the fit, I still could not find a setup that honestly feels good to wear. You know, during my first few days with Vision Pro, the weight didn't bother me as much. I think I was kind of more excited by the headset software and all the capabilities. Now it's at the point where a few minutes after I put this thing on, I want to take it off. Another awkward thing about the Vision Pro is that it's powered by an external tethered battery pack. Whenever you're using the headset, you have to have this thing attached and you have to have this brick on you at all times. Not the biggest con, but definitely kind of a frustrating trade-off. You do have to stay mindful of this chunky piece of aluminum anytime you want to get up and move around with your Vision Pro. When the Vision Pro software is working together, it truly feels like magic. When it's not, it's incredibly frustrating. I have run into a good number of bugs, including the headset just suddenly not really responding well to my eye movements, to my hand gestures. There are already software updates coming out to address these things, so the headset is always improving. But I definitely have had my fair share of moments of, you know, wanting to just use a regular old 2D device. Another downside of the Vision Pro is that it's kind of an isolating device. I mean, that's kind of the nature of any VR headset. This does have a feature called EyeSight, which will show kind of a digital recreation of your eyes to people you're talking to, but that just feels eerie and very Black Mirror-y in a way that I don't love. So this is also not a very easy device to share with other people. There is kind of a guest mode where you could give it to someone else and they could try it out, but you have to manually engage it every time you want to pass the headset off. So it's not this simple kind of pass and play type of thing, which is disappointing because it's such a cool headset and you want to show people what it's capable of. If you live alone, it's great. If you're constantly around other people, this might not be for you. Last but not least, we have to talk about the price. I actually don't think the $3,500 asking price is as exorbitant as it may initially seem when you really boil down what this device can do. This is something that can ostensibly replace your 4K TV, your computer, and your monitor setup, which those things can easily run you thousands of dollars on your own. And while there's nothing that does exactly what the Vision Pro does, there are a lot of affordable alternatives. Of course, there's the MetaQuest 3, our favorite overall VR headset. You could buy about 7 of those for the price of one of these, outfit the whole family in VR. You'll get a much better gaming selection. You'll get still pretty good pass-through and pretty good mixed reality, even if it's not quite as immersive as what's on here. So, should you buy the Apple Vision Pro? For, I'd say, 99.9% of people, the answer is a firm not yet. This product is really exciting when everything's working. It truly feels magical. I know I've said that a lot, but it really is. It's a great entertainment device if you want your own personal home theater. It really does shine as a multitasking machine, especially if you have a Mac, but the software is not quite there yet. And more importantly, it just doesn't feel good to wear. To me, that's an even bigger deal breaker than the exorbitant price, because if this is something we're meant to be using for hours at a time, for it not to be comfortable kind of defeats the whole purpose. And this is a first generation product. I could very easily see, you know, 3-4 Vision Pro generations from now, we have a device that's small, more like a standard pair of glasses that you could comfortably wear around. But for now, this is very much a wait for the next version, because there are a lot of things that need to be worked out. Thank you.